Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Once we have created a Django project, the next step is to normally create a Django application. Let's go through the process and understand a little bit more about the differences between a Django project and a Django app and learn how to create a new Django application. Another note we can create here is how to start a new app. To start a new app, we're going to be utilizing the start app command. Again, a nice easy command to remember because it easily describes or it nicely describes what it is that we're trying to achieve here. Now, there are a few different options here. Now, this is three commands, but they all perform the same action. Whether you're using Mac or Linux or Windows, you might use a different command. Now, if you are using Mac or Linux, in actual fact, you don't need to ever type Python 3 at the start. Simply use ./, so dot be in the current folder, slash, inside of this current folder, start the manage.py file. So we don't need to specify that we want to run Python or Python command. And then we use the keyword startup. You can see that whatever approach you take, we use the keyword startup. So that's the command that's going to start an app. Now, this is expecting, at a minimum, the name of the app that we want to build. So here we're going to specify new app. Now we can also specify the location of where we want to create this new folder, this new app, but we don't in this instance because we're just going to be utilizing the root folder. Or should I say the root project folder. Right, so something you'll notice here then, whether you're on Mac or Linux, you can use the ./ approach or potentially the Python 3 approach here. So type in Python 3, then the command as per normal. If you're running Windows, the likelihood is you're going to access Python utilizing py and then space manage.py and so on. So remember the name of the app that we're building here is going to be called new app. You can replace that with any name that you want to use. When I say likewise with starting a new project, you can use any name. That's strictly not correct. You can't use any name. There are some names which will be reserved in your programming language or maybe reserved in your framework that you're using. So you do need to be careful. So I just recommend for now that you follow my lead here and naming to avoid some of those common issues. Now they will be fairly rare, but it is just something to think about later on when we start building your own applications. So we're going to start off where we finished in the previous tutorial. So I'll go ahead and I've just cleared my screen. Now I might want to press Control and C. That is going to close the server. That's what we're told. If you're using Windows, it probably Control C rather than Command and C. Right, so that closes the server. So I'll just show you that again. Run server, it does tell you here how to close Control C. So if you type in Control C or press Control C, that will close the server. Right, so let's create a new app. Like I said, when I explained the command to create a new app, you can place the new app wherever you like, and you may see different approaches in different applications that you might inspect online or in different tutorials. Some like to actually place the apps inside of your core project folder because then it nicely places everything in one folder. It kind of makes sense almost. This is your core folder. Inside of your core folder, you'll find app folders. And some approaches are slightly different. You'll find apps inside of this root directory. Now, for the purpose of this course, I'm going to be utilizing the core directory here, or the, root directory here of a project to create applications. Let's go ahead and use your approach, preferred approach here. I'm going to use the ./ approach. If you're in Windows, remember, you might want to type in py, space manage.py, and then start app, and then the name of the app. So I'm going to create a new app called new app. So the default behavior here, you can see that we've created a new folder, or Django's created a new folder. Inside of this, it creates some new files that we can utilize to build our application. You might be wondering, why do we create a new project and then create new apps? So the general approach here is that we want to build an application, but in small components. So by creating our application, the whole application in the smaller components, it can make it easier to manage and build our application. So the approach here then is that we create a new project folder. So that was core. Inside of here, inside of our project core folder, this is the main project folder where we can configure the project as a whole. And the whole idea here is that when we want to start to build our new project, we create applications or application folders. And that allows us to break down the project into smaller components. And like I said, that can make it easier to manage and build our application. So if we were, for example, building an e-commerce project or an e-commerce website, we may have, for example, a product folder or project app. So this app is going to be designed to manage all the products in our application. So for example, in here, we might create code to allow users to build, create, manage products. And then of course, we might have, for example, another app. So this app here is going to be designed to manage customers. So this app will be designed and built to allow interactions such as customer logins, logout, changing passwords, and so on. So you can see here that in actual fact, the functionality of this app isn't necessarily connected to the building products or managing products. So it allows us to build smaller chunks of our application where we know we can logically define and build certain aspects of our application inside of a smaller chunk, that chunk being an application here, and so on. So imagine we wanted to, for example, build a checkout of some sort. Well, we could build a new app here, and let's just call these apps. So we have a customer app, and now we have a checkout app. So this app is going to be designed and built to manage everything about our checkout. So like I said, we can build our project so that all these apps here are outside of our core project. We may prefer to actually kind of build everything within the core project, like I showed you before. And that really isn't going to change anything about our project other than the fact that everything will be kind of nicely contained within our core folder. I will just take you through the process of creating a new project inside of our core folder. Now, there's two approaches to this, so I will take you through both. Now, notice that I've deleted the new app folder here. So I've done that first. So let's create our new app inside of the core folder here. Right, so what we need to do, what we can do, is we can use commands or we can use the features here to create a new folder. So I'll take you through the command approach. So here on the Mac, I'm going to type in mkdir. I'm going to make a new directory. And that directory is going to be in the core. And inside of core, I'm going to make it a new folder called new app. So this command here, if I go inside of core now, you can see I've got a new folder, an empty folder called new app. Of course, I could just right click here and select new folder. That would build a new folder. So now I have a new folder. Let's use the command I used earlier. So I pressed up on the keyboard to bring up previous commands. And now what I can do is I can specify where I want to start my new app. So I do want to call it new app, so new app. And then I can specify .core and then /new app. So you can see now what's happened is everything now that we saw previously when we created a new app in the root directory, root project directory, now appears in this new folder. I do recommend you follow this course the approach taken in this course, because how we approach registering these apps, something that we'll cover later in this course, will be slightly different if you take this approach. But I want you to understand that you may find different projects utilizing different approaches. They're slightly different. Ultimately, the outcome is the same. Just for manageability for some projects, potentially, some might prefer to utilize this type of approach. So let's go ahead and just delete our new app again. This does give us an excuse to build a new app again and just remind ourselves of the commands that we need to utilize. So here again, I'm going to use /manage.py start app. So I will just show you here on the Mac, I can just type in Python 3 manage.py start app new app. And you can see we've created our new app again.